Russian pilot has killed a diplomat on the tarmac of National Airport, then shot a second victim, who we've been told is an NSA agent identified as Edward Ballinger. Ballinger, who remains comatose
at County Hospital,
was attempting to stop the assassination of the diplomat when he himself was wounded.
Eddie.
You know him?
Yes. I did.
He was a pretender, too.
Towards the end of my captivity, I found out that there were others in the pretender program. They kept us separated for the most part. Then I found Eddie, and we did something. Something special. We escaped tonight.
Daddy, are you here?
Hello? I don't think anybody's here. Hello?
Unless he's eating beef and Merlot for breakfast, he was here last night.
Something tells me he wasn't watching an old Western movie.
What do you want?
Your father was watching a DSA of you and Mr. Raines?
It's the last time I saw Mr. Raines alive.
Before she died, my mother said something about her unfinished work, about her plan. What did she mean by that?
It's about what everything's about, Miss Parker. It's about the center, all the lies. Just remember, whatever answers your mother may have left behind, there is still one person alive who does know the whole truth.
Who?
Daddy. Right for my little girl to have blood like that on her hands.
Miss Parker, I'm getting a pretty weird feeling about this.
Everything about my family is weird, including the last time I saw my father, just after he murdered Raines.
Last time I saw my father, he just sculpted the shrubs into Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
I guess everyone's family is weird in their own way. Daddy's bed hasn't been slept in, and I think I know why. Something must have spooked him, and while he was on the phone, he was attacked.
Yeah, but who was he calling?
Let's find out.
This is Lyle.
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Dim sum and then some. You two look good enough to eat.
Hate to mess with your lunch plans, but we need to talk.
Is this one of those talks I get to participate in or just listen?
Where's our father?
I haven't seen or heard from him in a couple of days.
Not even a phone call?
Nor message from carrier pigeon. Is there a problem?
He's not at home, and it appears he may have left under duress.
Well, I'm not calling out the cavalry on possibilities, like the possibility that in your present state, you misinterpreted what you saw.
And what state would that be?
We've all heard about your imagination running wild since the Big Bang.
I didn't say anything.
Speaking of which, word from the sweeper team is that Jarod and Ethan both survived the explosion. So I want the pursuit of Jarod back in full motion. Have you heard anything?
No.
Not even any voices from within.
Why don't you shove your nine fingers where the sun don't shine?
Love to, but that would still leave me one to get tanned.
Oh, you got a new thumb?
Actually, it's a pre-owned model, but I got a great deal on it, considering Mr. Raines wasn't using it anymore.
You harvested Mr. Raines' thumb?
Waste not, want not. Don't worry about Dad. He'll turn up. He always does. Ladies.
Just can't trust a man with a stolen thumb. Check Frankenstein's phone records. Find out if he's had any more contact with my father.
What the hell does it mean?
It's Agent Ballinger's investigation notes. It looks like it's written backwards, but I can't make heads or tails of it.
It says he feared the assassin would kill the Russian diplomat. Looks like he was right. It's written in Apache.
You can read Apache.
Nanihi. Come on, Apache. It was a code that the Americans used during World War II. This is the NSA, isn't it?
Do you have business with Agent Ballinger?
You know him.
He's my partner.
Ah, Agent Zane. Thank you. Agent Jarod Morse. Your new partner. I was sent by the agency to uncover and stop the terrorist who attempted to kill Agent Ballinger.
Top of your class at the academy. Doctorate with honors in anti-terrorist tactics from Harvard, no less. And yet I've never heard of you.
Well, I've heard of you. Agent Andrea Zane, middle of her class at the academy, and a 5.5-year criminology graduate at Crawford College. I do my homework.
That was my problem. I rarely did.
So what do we know about the assassin?
Not enough, that's for sure. InfoSec is codenamed him the Chameleon.
Why Chameleon?
Because our bad boy's a genius who can become anybody he wants to be.
So what do you hear when you see all of the things Jarod worked on before he escaped? The red notebooks detailing the victimized people our twisted Robin Hood has helped. The items of self-discovery that he's left behind since we've been chasing him. What do you hear?
I hear the child desperately looking for his mother. The man in her child's body making these incredible discoveries. And sometimes I just hear simple soul wondering who he really is. And I hear my own voice echoing with guilt because I contributed to the theft of Jarod's life.
I guess we can all hear that.
But not everyone can hear like you. Mine are mostly memories, things everyone experiences. Yours, like your mother's before you, are the planes of sensory perception. The gift of the inner sense, when your mother rescues you in your vision. That is what she is trying to tell you, to focus on your inner sense.
You sound unnaturally sure of yourself.
And that's what scares me so. Tell me, Miss Parker, in your vision, when your mother reaches out, the glint of light from her tear-shaped diamond ring flashes in front of your eyes, does it not?
I didn't tell you about the ring.
But your mother did. When she was your age, she had that exact same vision, and she came to see me to ask for my help in developing her innocence, to find out what it meant.
Will you do the same for me?
That's what I was afraid you would ask.
Why?
Shortly after I helped Catherine Parker, she was gone.
We don't know how or why he's doing what he's doing, but the Chameleon is an assassin who's been unmasking and then killing the NSA's deepest undercover spies.
Is there any clue who he is?
Not a one. The guy slides into a different skin everywhere he goes. His last four personas were as an Arab sheik, a Bosnian general, an IRA militia fighter, the latest, of course, the Russian pilot. But he never so much as leaves a fingerprint behind. Well, this guy loves to play, and right now we're in a major game of tag.
Tag?
You're it. Catch me if you can. You know the kids' schoolyard game?
They didn't play that where I went to school.
Those are the four victims so far. Agent Ballinger was convinced that the Chameleon was planning two major assassinations on our soil. That in Chameleon's words would affect someone important to your world. The first was the Russian diplomat. The second is anybody's guess.
Is this Eddie's family?
Yeah, Eddie has everything a person could want.
One day, I'm gonna find my parents. One day, I'm gonna have a family of my own.